Town of Greece versus Galloway asks the question whether or not it's constitutional under the First Amendment Establishment Clause for a city council to begin its meetings with a prayer, sort of generally called the legislative prayer. But the facts of Town of Greece, the specific facts of Town of Greece, actually turn out to be somewhat important in the analysis of the lower courts.
The facts in Town of Greece are quite important because they involve the legislative prayers led by Christian clergymen for over a decade that opened up town meetings. It turns out that virtually all of the prayers were led by Christian clergymen, and many of those prayers referred specifically to Jesus or the Holy Ghost. They were very much sectarian, going beyond the so-called Judeo-Christian ethic. And people who objected to that over this period made their voices known in about 2007, 2008, and there was a bit of a change for a while with other non-Christian clergymen offering the prayers. But then, since that time, back to the Christian clergymen and back to many of these very sectarian kinds of prayers.
So the challenge here is not to the notion of legislative prayer in general. It is to this particular practice.
Exactly correct. There has been one legislative prayer decision in the history of the Supreme Court that I'm aware of, and that's Marsh versus Chambers in 1983. And in that case, the Supreme Court held that it was constitutional for the Nebraska legislature to have a paid chaplain open up legislative sessions with legislative prayers. The prayers in that case were not as sectarian as the prayers in this case, and the Supreme Court in Marsh v. Chambers relied on the history of the First Amendment, interestingly enough, because the court said, among other things, the framers of the First Amendment were very much aware of what the First Amendment was all about, and yet they approved chaplains who were paid by Congress to lead opening prayers before sessions of Congress.
And so, they still do today.
And they still do today. So that's the major precedent, although the related question, apart from that precedent, is what test the Supreme Court is going to use with respect to scrutinizing the constitutionality of these legislative prayers. May I add to that, by the way, that what we're talking about is not one prayer in particular or even a dozen prayers. We're talking about a pattern or practice, an alleged pattern or practice, for over a decade, because the challenge here is not just to what the town should do in the future, but I believe this is also a Section 1983 damages action against the town, seeking damages, whatever those might be, compensatory damages, emotional distress, we don't know, from the Second Circuit's opinion. So the challenge is to what the town has done before and whether that violates the Establishment Clause.